反對是透過這個緊急條例的一個規則是去立這個蒙面法的。首先我想提出就是亦想提醒香港人，就是當日說要去訂立這個逃犯條例、送中條例的是誰呢？是民建聯，始作俑者的是民建聯，搞到香港今日這樣的境地是民建聯有份的。而這些這人呢，他們想事的方式永遠就是覺得有個問題在這裡，那就不如立一條法例，而不去理這條法例呢所引申出來對於香港法治人權的破壞和種種的後果。今日民建聯從思故忌，在這裡見到一個所謂問題，跟著呢就作一個惡法出來，是嘗試進一步去箝制香港人的自由，破壞香港的法治。而這個正正就是建制派永遠都跳不出的思維，就是亦都是當日他們搞這個送中條例令到香港呢是到這個境地。第二就是我想強調呢，就是我們不認為亦都看不到呢，你立這個蒙面法是可以解決到現在香港的撕裂，解決到現在香港的問題。而你去強硬推這個蒙面法，還要是透過緊急條例這樣去推，只會將香港的氣氛撕裂呢是加劇去擴大，這個是完全解決不到問題。第三就是透過這個緊急法呢去立這個蒙面法呢，將會是香港跌入一個極權社會的第一步。因為點解呢？他今天用得這個緊急條例去立這個蒙面法，明天他可以說，今天湯家驊說了，他可以延長那個的這個拘禁時候到96小時或者以上，或者隨時運人入新屋嶺行政拘留15天，或者是甚至將人遞解出境。這些就是一開始用這個緊急條例是不能收回，只會是讓行政機關在沒有這個立法會的監管底下，在完全不尊重香港人的人權底下，是進一步一步這樣是蠶食香港人的自由和人權。當然政府現在未必會認的，但是當年他在聯合國1999年11月的一份文件裏面的第43段說得很清楚，就是他說如果我用這個緊急法的時候，我一定會回到立法會。這個是他當日1999年11月的時候白字黑字向聯合國作的一個承諾，就說他會回立法會。咁我相信你大家可以即管問下行政長官，如果佢真係立呢一條咁樣嘅蒙面法，透過緊急條例嘅話，佢會唔會翻嚟立法會？而家立法會幾時開翻？行政長官仍然未有一個正式嘅公告，而當日就係話一定會透過立法會去立呢一個緊急法，但係而家咧，而家會唔會咁做咧？同埋喺法律上咧，有一個位係好清楚嘅，任何嘅這個緊急條例底下的規定呢都是不可以違反基本法，都是不可以凌駕基本法，還有呢違反這個國際人權公約裡面所定下的一些人權，是這些是絕對不可以違反的。還有一件事，就是香港人有他自己本身的自由在這裡，大家戴口罩可能有很多原因，如果一個人他是確實有這樣的需要去戴口罩的，你不讓他戴，甚至呢如果他戴口罩，你認為他斷定他是一個違法的行為，是有刑事的，這個我相信呢會有人呢是會提這個司法覆核的。那我暫時講住這幾點先，有沒有什麼問題？
在政策上說過說這個緊急法是可以違反的基本法，其實可不可以講得清楚，究竟即是如果用緊急法去立法的話，是有些什麼的基本法的條例或者人權公約是違反到，就係、是，即係如果真係立咗法國條例，執行上有啲咩困難？就係、是、如果用緊急法去立呢條法，即係立法嘅話，有啲咩後續影響？或者可唔可以取消埋即係區選或者
延後區選
呢、這個
做一啲嘅？首先咧，喺法律嘅呢一個定位上面咧，香港冇一條任何一條法例係可以違反基本法，係可以去違反咧基本法裏邊嘅。就住一些人權保障的條文，尤其是係國際人權公約基本法第39条咧，係講明就係裏邊嘅權利咧係香港嘅人權嘅一部分，而係不能夠違反。 咁所以話咧，就係如果你用呢一個緊急法去定任何嘅法例咧，都要按照基本法，都唔可以脱離香港基本法裏面，尤其是就住人權嘅保障。咁人權嘅保障當然係包括人身自由啊、表達自由啊、宗教自由啊等等嘅一方面。嗱，我唔知道而家政府係咪真係推？如果佢真係推嘅話，究竟條法例裏面會唔會有基本嘅人權保障咧？如果冇嘅，我相信有人會拎呢一條條文去作呢個司法覆核，就係話究竟係唔係可以政府係完全唔理會香港人嘅人權保障，係夾硬立呢條咁樣嘅緊急法？我相信法庭會有一個定斷。咁至於你頭先講話啊，佢會唔會進一步係取消區議會選舉啊？會唔會進一步去鉛制香港人嘅人權啊？嗱，呢個問得好好，正正就係今日湯家驊都講啦，遲啲咪扣留你九十六個鐘頭咯。佢一開始咗呢一個用緊急法嘅一個做法嘅時候咧，其實佢引申咗好多一步一步會係鉛制香港人嘅自由同埋權利嘅做法嘅。咁可能就係話會取消區議會啦，可能唔俾人出街啦，戒嚴啦，拘留人哋行政拘留15天啦，或者係甚至遞解人出境都有可能。咁所以呢啲咧，我哋係絕對認為冇乜需要，同埋咧係解決唔到香港而家問題。I just want to say a few words in English.
Yeah.
So basically, we say that there is absolutely no need for an anti-mask law in Hong Kong. And we do not see how an anti-mask law will actually resolve the current situation in Hong Kong. Because the people of Hong Kong understand that we have the crisis, of course, in our hands. But by having more laws imposed on the Hong Kong people, that willrestrict and seriously curtail the basic human rights and freedoms of the Hong Kong people will only make the matter worse. I hope the authorities by now should have listened to the Hong Kong people that their yearning for freedom, liberty and democracy are not going to go away simply because you enact even more draconian laws to suppress the human rights of the Hong Kong people. And I stress that this emergency regulation, if used, will damage the rule of law in Hong Kong.It will serve to further restrict the human rights and freedom of the Hong Kong people. Even though this emergency regulation cannot violate the basic human rights of the Hong Kong people, they are not allowed to contravene the provisions of the Basic Law and the ICCPR. Back in 1919, the government has made a written representation to the United Nations.Saying that if they are ever to use the emergency regulations power, they have to come back to LegCo for allow the Legislative Council to scrutinize that piece of legislation. But obviously, they're going to walk back on that promise. But I want to put it on record that they have promised that they will put the legislation in front of Legislative Council for LegCo to scrutinize it. But I'm sure they're going to walk back on it. But they have made such a promise. So,The emergency regulation is only the start of the beginning of a slip towards the authoritarian state. Reason is because they can use it to enact an anti-mask law now. The next thing is they're going to extend the detention period. And the next is they're going to further curtail the Hong Kong people's rights and freedoms, including cancelling district council election, or in the name of using the emergency regulation. And that is our biggest fear.I answer your second question first. You're right, there are other democratic countries around the world that has anti-mask law, but they are democratic countries, and we're not. Do we have universal suffrage? Is this Legislative Council accountable to the Hong Kong people? Is the executive branch of government accountable to the Hong Kong people? The answer is no. And that is why we are extremely concerned about the use of further emergency regulations power to curtail the freedoms and the rights of the Hong Kong people. So we do not see...Hong Kong needing this law, and we do not see how this law, even if enacted, can help resolve the situation. Is it going to resolve the situation? Are people going to stay home just because there's an anti-mask law? Hasn't the government listened to the Hong Kong people's yearning and aspiration for freedom and democracy and liberty? That having more draconian laws imposed upon them is not going to help resolve the situation. And it was the DAB who was the first person, one of the first people, who pushed for the extradition bill. It was the DAB. So what have, how has that gotten us to this situation? It was thanks to people like the DAB who think that having any problems in society can be resolved through the enactment of more draconian laws. Let's not forget that. And also, my concern, as I said just now in Chinese, is that when they start using this emergency regulation, they won't stop here. You know, they're not going to stop at anti-mask law. Next weekend, oh, they see that people are using a different way to express their opinion. They will shut down the internet. They will further restrict people's freedom of expression, stop people going to church or any sort of gathering, and cancel elections. We know that the district council election is coming up. Ronnie Tong, executive councillor, suggests that they could extend the detention time to 96 hours or even longer, or even deporting people out of Hong Kong. So all these are possible. So we must not allow them. We must tell the international community and the Hong Kong people very clearly that this is the beginning of a full authoritarian state that will be imposed on the Hong Kong people.你三條問題，第一條咧就係、我哋見到係冇錯，其他民主國家係有呢啲蒙面法，但係人哋係民主國家嘛，我哋係咪有民主嘅制度啊？冇，呢個佢連立法會佢可能都唔會經過立法會嘅審議一個蒙面法，呢個第一。第二，立法會根本上唔係全面民主產生。第三就係大家都知道呢個行政長官係完全唔聽香港人嘅聲音，完全冇任何民主嘅成分喺裏邊嘅。咁你點樣去同人哋嗰啲國家相比呢 ？OK， 呢個第一。第二就係你透過呢個緊急條例去通過呢個蒙面法，而呢個緊急條例咧就是、行政長官話一禁制，佢就係生效。到佢認為冇需要再用嘅時候咧，佢只停止嘅。咁但係呢個行政長官呢個決定唔係一個民主嘅決定，唔係好似其他民主國家咁樣係一個民主嘅議會。去要佢問責嘅，咁佢講話呢個緊急法嘅使用咧，係可以用到幾時唔知道，可以用到幾闊亦都唔知道。佢今日話蒙面法，聽日佢就唔俾你集會，第三就唔俾你喺網上寫嘢，第四就係、是、行政拘留15天或者更長嘅時間，第五就係頭先你講啦，就係、是、如果香港社會去到咧係要取消選舉嘅。點解要取消選舉啊？好明顯啊，畫公仔唔使畫出牆。建制派驚區選會輸，咁咧就諗條計出嚟啦，就開始用呢、這、一個緊急法。跟住咧就到時咧呢一、這個市況會更加亂嘅時候咧，佢就話不如取消選舉。呢、這個係成個計劃好清楚嘅，成個原意就係因為佢哋驚輸啊嘛，驚輸咪取消選舉咯，政府咪同建制派扯貓尾咯。嗱，我可以話俾你聽，如果國際社會見到香港咧係開始取消選舉嘅時候，或者用呢個緊急法咧，呢、這個就係我哋邁向極權嘅一個最清楚不過嘅一個事實。Any other questions? Okay, thank you.
Sorry.